Her inquiry, laden with the implications of our shared future and the well-being of our son, leaves me grappling with the magnitude of the choices that lie ahead. The moment she articulated the idea, it transitioned from fleeting contemplation to a profound reality. The notion of forging a conventional family unit for my son, where I am more than a sporadic presence in his life, began to deeply resonate with me. Yet, the thought of leaving my wife, the woman who embodies my past affections and dreams, for a situation birthed from indiscretion, seemed inherently unjust. The conflict between honoring the family I envisioned with my wife and the potential of a new family with my son and his mother put me at a crossroads, each path fraught with its own set of sacrifices. After a period of silence, an invitation from my wife sparked a glimmer of hope for reconciliation. However, the hope quickly dissolved as I was met with the somber reality of divorce proceedings in the home we once shared. The strength and beauty she exhibited in that moment are etched into my memory, a poignant reminder of all that was lost in the wake of my decisions. In the midst of my despair, an unexpected development occurred. The woman who was once a secret became a pivotal part of my future. Her evolution into motherhood and our shared preparations for our child began to fill the void left by my broken marriage. This emerging connection led me to embrace this new direction, culminating in a proposal and plans for a life together. As we settled into our new existence, welcoming our son and later anticipating the arrival of our daughter, I found myself navigating the duality of loss and newfound love. The memory of my first love lingers, a bittersweet testament to the consequences of my actions, yet the presence of my new family offers a glimmer of redemption and the promise of renewal. Amidst my ongoing turmoil and pain, I find myself rediscovering love, DJ, albeit in a novel context, VDJ, with the woman who will soon be my wife and the mother of my children. This burgeoning love for my son and his mother suggests a possibly predestined path, a form of redemption for my past transgressions. The shadows of my previous actions linger, with the weight of guilt ever present. Yet, I hold on to the hope that, over time, I will come to terms with myself, fully accepting and cherishing the second chance at life and love that fate has bestowed upon me. This narrative unfolds as a solemn confession from a heart besieged by turmoil. I've erred gravely, plunging into chaos I scarcely comprehend how to amend. My spouse, the quintessence of my world, embodies grace and warmth, her presence a light in my darkest times. Our union, now 6 years strong and bound in matrimony for half that time, harbors dreams of nurturing life together, a testament to our bond. Yet, in a lapse of judgment, I veered, succumbing to a fleeting desire that I fooled myself into believing was harmless. This indiscretion wasn't love, but a chase for excitement, hidden from the world. The narrative takes a harrowing turn months ago, as I resolved to sever this secret dalliance, haunted by the innocence in my wife's dreams of parenthood. However, the revelation of my affair partner's pregnancy shattered any semblance of control I had over this double life. Faced with the impending reality of fatherhood under such complicated circumstances, I'm torn between conflicting joys and despairs. The prospect of co-parenting with someone for whom my feelings pale in comparison to those for my wife presents an unimaginable crossroads. My son, an innocent party in this turmoil, deserves a father's commitment, yet I yearn for the life I envisioned with my wife. The weight of the decisions before me is suffocating, fraught with potential heartache and the daunting task of seeking forgiveness where it may seem impossible. I lay bare my failings, not in search of absolution, but in a desperate plea for guidance. The question of whether to forge a new path with my affair partner or face the challenges of supporting my child from afar, all while clinging to the hope of reconciliation with my wife, is one I cannot answer alone. Stories of forgiveness fuel my hope, yet I'm acutely aware of the fragile nature of love and trust once betrayed. Can a marriage endure through such a storm? Is it just to bind my wife to the repercussions of my actions? In my quest for clarity, I turn to the collective insight of strangers, hoping for a sliver of light on a path shrouded in darkness. At this critical juncture, I find myself grappling with the repercussions of my actions, enmeshed in a web of deceit that I spun. This is my admission of guilt and a desperate call for guidance. My affection for my wife knows no bounds, and the thought of being present for my son is paramount. Yet the escape from this intricate maze seems elusive, with every turn revealing more barriers. I am open to any wisdom that might illuminate my path. The counsel I received from a specialized forum ranged from stern reprimands to empathetic guidance. The consensus underscores the necessity of facing my wife with the truth, despite the harrowing consequences that may ensue, including the potential dissolution of our marriage and the inevitability of child support obligations. The emphasis on honesty as the foundation for any possibility of healing resonated through the advice, alongside recommendations for professional counseling to navigate the aftermath of my disclosure. Compelled by this collective wisdom, I mustered the courage to unveil my betrayal to my wife. In the familiarity of our living room, a space once brimming with joy, I laid bare the entirety of my indiscretion without seeking absolution or mitigating my culpability. The impact of my confession was palpable, not marked by anger, but by a profound and silent devastation that spoke volumes of the hurt inflicted. In a somber revelation, she remained eerily calm, her silence speaking volumes more than any outburst could. She requested time and space, via a hiatus from the life we knew, to gather her thoughts amidst the wreckage of trust I had laid bare. Though not a demand for divorce, the temporary exile from our shared sanctuary was her plea for clarity. The solemnity of my departure, marked by her concealed sobs, underscored the profound sorrow of our parting. As I sought refuge in a nondescript rental, devoid of the warmth and history of our home, the constant updates from my affair partner served as bittersweet reminders of the life continuing outside my penance. Despite the growing anticipation of fatherhood, the chasm between my desires for reconciliation with my wife and the impending responsibilities as a father deepens. My days are now a labyrinth of regret and yearning, teetering on the precipice of an uncertain future. The silence from my wife is a torturous void, filled only with the hope of forgiveness and the daunting possibility of mending what was shattered. Meanwhile, my child's mother undergoes her evolution, her newfound resolve towards motherhood painting her in a light of maturity and determination previously unnoticed. Confronted with her unexpected proposition of forming a family unit, I'm thrust into a vortex of reflection.